52-1, one of those feel-good movies, is about to hit theaters on April 4th. And you know what? We are excited because we're going to get to talk to the cast. They say that dreams don't have an expiration date. So let's go ahead and talk to them about what this message is all about, 52-1.
And the inspiration really came about less than 5 years ago. I was in Los Angeles, sitting on my couch, watching television with a beer in hand, as a lot of people are, watching the Kentucky Derby. Mm-hmm. And I watched the most amazing visual display of an equine. This thoroughbred came around with all this mud, came from 30 lengths back, put the whoop on everybody else, went flying by him, and I said, oh my gosh, who is that? And this horse was 50-1, this crazy horse, mind that bird, diminutive little crooked horse. And I said, oh my gosh, if there's more to this story, we got to find that out. So Faith and I, who's right here, there's Faith. And Faith and I flew down to Roswell, New Mexico, and we met these owners and the trainer. And these guys are these cowboys who are black-hatted, black-leathered underdogs themselves. And I said, here's a group I've got to follow. And to take these guys on their... you know, on their path to Kentucky was the sort of story I wanted. Fish out of water, underdog tale. I think those are great. So that's was the inspiration for me.
Well, you know, this thing, Jim and Faith were so fortunate to be on this thing. I mean, a lot of times you sit back in Los Angeles and you do a movie and you just pray that it does well. You know what I mean? You don't get to go out there. You don't get to see what's going on. Well, not this time. We're on a bus and we're getting out there and we're shaking hands and we're seeing people and they walk out of the theater. You know, it doesn't come out in Texas till April 4th, but there was some incident. There was a couple times in New Mexico we came out and they came out of the theater and, you know, grown men, cowboys, I mean, tough guys like I grew up with, were walking out with tears in their eyes after seeing this. And that means it means the world to us. We tried to bring out this emotion in this film because it's a story that I think needs to be told. And we did it, and we're shaking hands, and every once in a while you get a hug, and it means the world to us. And you don't get that with movies. You get it with music and other things, but you never get to get on a bus and go see the people and meet the people that you made this movie for. So we've been very fortunate. Maddie?
I'm struggling so much right now. I'm having a full-blown, like, giggle fit right now. I'm so sorry. I've been well-behaved this entire trip up until this moment.
We laughing in church a little bit.
But he does this thing where he's trying to hide it, and he starts wheezing. He was just wheezing through Jim's whole bit. I'm just struggling really hard right now. It's catchphrase. It's so great. I'm gonna pass the mic.
This is our leading. This is our leading lady, Madeline Deutsch. Okay. And completely out of control. The reason I cast. She's not gonna struggle anymore. Watch this. I'll direct her now. She at age 4 started riding horses. She not only was looking for a beautiful young woman, someone who could ride horses and all that stuff, but Maddie, back on it now, and tell her how has it been like on this tour?
Okay. No, this has been an amazing experience. I mean, Jim and Faith are super innovative human beings. I mean, to kind of skip the whole studio model and actually make an independent film that doesn't look like an independent film. They didn't treat us like it was an independent film. You know, we actually ate and had toilets, and it was amazing. Seriously, it was such an improvement, let me tell you. And to do this whole bus tour, I mean, I've never heard of anybody doing anything like this before. Letting us play catchphrase has been really great. It's been super eye-opening because it's easy to get really jaded when you work in this business, and you know, it's like, okay, we're gonna go out and do all these meet and greets, and you're like, god, you know, I hope anyone shows up, you know, is like the first thing you think. And then literally, like, you know, we've had like 200-300 people showing up at these meet and greets and so excited, and even people who are just on the sidewalk and they're like, what's this all about, and they meander over, and it's like, I'm so excited because the first weekend's over and it's working, you know what I mean? And it's open only in New Mexico, and like the numbers are really great. The response is like so enthusiastic. People are telling their friends and family, taking their kids and going 2-3 times, which is like, you know, people don't do that. So it's just really exciting to be a part of it and to see that their sort of leap of faith is working. Ooh, yes.
Well, one of the things that I'm proud to be a part of this production, I've worked on a television show called True Blood that's dark, and it's about vampires and adult themes. And while I enjoy that and I enjoy those kind of movies, this has been a new experience to work on something that has a very positive, very family values driven message behind it. And it's something you can bring your toddler to, well, if you can keep quiet, and your grandmother, if she can keep quiet. But it's a, or awake. It's a family movie. Happy to be here. I think it's going to play really well in Texas and the Midwest. We open on April 4th, and I'm excited to see how people respond to it in this part of the country.
So far is the best experience for me. I haven't worked with people so passionate and enthusiastic and driven and humble like Jim Gunson and Faith Conroy. So I feel very fortunate to be here with them and all the other cast members. Yeah.